Good morning, students. First, you prepare a WhatsApp group, and my phone number is this one 0945680439. Added to this WhatsApp group. If you have any queries or problem, you can ask on that particular group. Now we are going to start with exercise. Our first question is: which of the following are matter? Chair, air, both are matter because they occupy space and having the mass. Love, smell, hate, these are not matter because they are the feelings. Elements, this is the matter. Thought and cold, these are also feelings. It is also not, these are not matter. Cold drink is matter, but smell of perfume is not matter. Perfume is matter, but smell of perfume is not matter. Now, exercise 2, give reason for the following observation. The smell of the sizzling food reaches you several meters away. But to get the smell from cold food, you have to go to close. What is the reason? As you know, the smell of the food reaches to you due to the diffusion of food particles through the air. But hot sizzling food have the high temperature. So, its rate of diffusion is faster. Hence, hot sizzling food reaches you several smell of hot sizzling food reaches you several meters away, but to get the smell from cold food you have to go close. Third exercise: a diver is able to cut through the water in a swimming pool. Which property of matter does this observation show? You know, diver's body particles have higher force of attraction than the water molecules. So when diver enter into the water, it can cut through the water, but water molecules have no force of attraction, so they give space to enter the diver's body in the swimming pool. So here, force of attraction characteristic of the matter is observed. What are the characteristic of particles of matter? You know, particles have three characteristics of matter. As you studied in the previous topic, previous class, that is, they have space between them, they are continuously moving, and they have force of attraction. Now we are starting the next topic, that is states of matter. We see three types of physical state around us: solid, liquid and gas. So our matter exists in three physical states: solid, liquid and gases. These states of matter arise due to variation in the characteristics of the particle of matter. Now one by one we discuss these three characteristics for these physical states. Number one, particles have space between them. Solid particles have very least space between them. For example, it can be represented particles of solid. They are in close association, very small space between them. These can be particles of liquid having sufficient space between them, and these are the particles of gases, very very far from each other, having big spaces between them. Now another characteristics, they are moving, their movement. So solid particles can vibrate at their own position only. They are very close to each other, no space to move here and there. Liquid particles, they can move here and there, but in the specified volume, they cannot go beyond the volume. Is it clear? And in gas particles, they can escape out from this given volume also. So they can go here and there, very big spaces, and move very very fast. So due to this one they can move here and there, their diffusion is also as very very fast. Now in case of solid particles are very close, no movement, and it is due to high force of attraction. So their force of attraction is very high. So they have fixed shape and fixed volume. But in case of liquids, they have space between them, and movement is only allowed in the given volume. So force of attraction is moderate, and in this case they can go here and there with the beyond the volume also, beyond the given volume also. So their force of attraction is very low. So high force of attraction, moderate force of attraction, and very low force of attraction in case of the gases. So on the basis of these three characteristics of matter, you can explain the different physical states of matter. Now, with the help of some activities, we are going to discuss them one by one. Number one, solid state. Collect some articles, pen, book, needle, piece of thread, etc. Sketch their shape on the paper. You will be able to sketch their shape because they have the definite shape, distinct boundaries, and fixed volume. If you hammer, pull, or drop them, what will happen? There is very less distortion in the shape, least compressibility, and all, they can break, but they cannot change their shape. If you keep them close to each other, they can't diffuse with each other. If you try to compress them, they show very less compressibility or no compressibility. So on the basis of our activity, we can say solids have definite shape, distinct boundaries, and fixed volume. They have negligible compressibility. Solids have a tendency to maintain their shape when subjected to outside force. Solids may break under force, but it is difficult to change their shape as they are rigid. They are not flexible. Rigid and flexible are opposite to each other. So our solids are rigid. Now we consider the following properties of different solid materials. What about a rubber band? Can it change its shape on stretching? Is it solid? Yes, it is solid, but on stretching it can change its shape. What is the reason? Because force of attraction among the particle is lesser. So on applying force, they can change its shape, but on releasing the force, they regain their shape again. Now, exercise B. What about sugar and salt? When kept in different jars, these take the shape of the jar. Are they solid? Yes, they are solid, because when you put them in the jar, particles are very small. They take the shape, they take the space, they take the position in different corners of the jar, and in this way they take the shape of the jar as a bulk. But individual particle of the sugar and salt have definite shape and definite volume, so we can say sugar and salts are solid. What about a sponge? It is solid, yet we are able to compress it. Why? Yes, sponge is also solid, but we are able to compress it because sponges have very minute pores filled with air. When we compress it, these air expelled from this sponge holes. When we remove the force, again sponge take its original shape and air enter into these gaps. This is the reason sponge is we are able to compress the sponge, even that is it is solid, because it regain, because it has definite shape and definite volume. Now, the liquid state, exercise 1.10, activity 1.10. Collect some articles, water, cooking oil, milk, juice, and cold drink. Containers of different shape of 50 ml volume. When you put these substances in these different containers, you will see that these substances take the shape of the given containers. It means they have no fixed shape, but when you measure their volume remain as such, that is 50 ml even you put it in any container. So it means they have the fixed volume.
So liquids, does the shape of the liquid remain the same? No, but their volume remains same. So on the basis of this, we can say liquids have no fixed shape but have fixed volume. They take up the shape of the container in which they are kept. Liquids flow and change shape, so they are not rigid but can be called fluids. Thank you.